I'm Teacher Shannon, and today we're doing a Grammar Bites takeover. So you get to listen to me tell you about some grammar, and I'll give you my tips on different ways that we can use it. Now, today we're going to talk about something that's a little bit trickier for people to understand and then use. So we'll talk about the present perfect simple against the present perfect continuous. It can be a little bit tricky to get your head around, but I'll help you through it. A lot of information on the board, so let me work through it with you. Now, when we use the past perfect simple, we use it to link the past with the present. Something that happened in the past is important for now. Now, what's important to remember about the past perfect simple is that we always use it for state verbs, or we often use it with quantities or numbers as well. So let me give you some examples here. I have known him all my life. Know is a state verb. If I know something, I know it. I can't be knowing it right now. I know it. It's a fact. So I have to use the simple form. I have known him all my life, since I was born until now. She has made 6 phone calls today. Have you been to Kuala Lumpur? And again, we're using our short answers. Yes, I have. Or for the negative, no, I haven't. Now, for our helping word, it's important to remember we have or has plus the past participle, also known as verb 3. Now, let's take a look at the present perfect continuous. Again, we're using it to link the past to the present, and it will probably continue in the future. Now, our helping words change this time. We're still using have or has, but we're adding been and verb ing. Again, verb ing to help make it continuous. So before we go through this, let's take a look at these different timelines over here. So we link the past to the present. We have 40 years ago until now. And again, it could continue afterwards. So let's take a look at our example for it. I have been working at this job for 40 years. Now, are they retired? Have they finished? No, not yet. So it's likely that they could continue working there for even longer. We can also look at another timetable. We can answer how long questions using for. So again, in the past, 10 years ago until now, potentially continuing in the future. He has been playing football for 10 years. He started 10 years ago and he played football and he can continue it into the future. He has been playing football for 10 years. Now, if you want to make it negative, can you guess what we do? He hasn't. The negative goes on the have or the has. He hasn't been playing football for 10 years. Maybe only 3 years. Now, what if I want to make it a question? It's as well. So how long have they been playing football together? They have been playing football together since 1996. They always play together. They have been playing together since 1996. Now, when we use the continuous, a really popular way of using it is when we have evidence of a situation. So maybe you walk home and your mom's in the kitchen and you see that there are dirty pots and pans in the kitchen. They are just everywhere and you can smell the food that's there. What has she been doing? Well, she has been cooking. We have evidence of it. Another great way is if you see someone really sweaty wearing shorts, they have on their trainer shoes, and they look like they're very tired. What have they been doing? They have been playing football, or maybe they have been running. That's how we use the continuous, using verb ing with it. So again, some important things to remember. If it is a state verb, a fact, we use the present perfect simple. If it's continuous, if we see evidence of it, or we want to use it with the verb ing, we go have or has plus been and verb ing. Keep quantity and numbers and state verbs up in the simple and look for that evidence, especially in the examples down below in a PDF where you can practice using these at home. Thanks for joining another Grammar Bites with me. I hope you enjoyed them, and remember, use the practice and then drop by and see us if you have any following questions. And remember, choose English, success will follow.